We shall now talk about arrays in C programming. Arrays are really important because they are so widely used in most of the programming tasks that it is really important to have a good grasp about what arrays are, how to use them, and how to get work done using arrays. Arrays are quite simple, so nothing to really be concerned of. First, let's try to understand or make a justification for why do we need arrays. So far, we have seen or used regular variables like integer I, j, a, b, etc. These variables I, j, a, b were able to hold only a single value. Okay, they could not hold more than one value in a single variable. Now, let's say I want to read 1000 names or I want to read 1000 examination IDs of students. So if I have to read 1000 examination ID of students, one option would be to create a program with 1000 variable names. There are a number of problems with it. Let's say from 1000, suddenly the number of students increases to 2000. Now you'll have to create 1000 more variable names. The problem with this is the program is going to be just so big, with all the program being simply names of variables, very difficult to understand, almost impossible to maintain. So in order to overcome this particular problem, almost all modern programming languages provide the facility for using an array. So regular variables hold a single value. Array is nothing but a collection of related values of the same data type, which can be referred to by a single name and a subscript. If we have a collection of different data types, that is structures, which we shall be dealing with in our future lectures. First, let's try to understand what is an array through an example. Let us say I declare something like this. I say int a of 10. What I have actually done here is I have declared an array A which can hold 10 numbers, all of the type integer data type. So let's see how this particular declaration looks in the main memory of the computer. Be sure this organization is merely a concept. Okay. So let us say this is the 10 blocks of memory location given to hold these 10 numbers. Let us say in each of those 10 locations, different values are stored. For example, in the first location 55, second 0, third minus 9, and in the last location 7. A few things you need to understand. Normally in real life, we start counting from 1. But in arrays, we start counting from 0. So 55 is considered to exist at the 0th location. 0 is considered to exist at the first location. Therefore, although I am declaring 10, since I am counting from 0, my maximum locations are going to be from 0 to 9. So suppose I had to refer to number 77. I would refer to number 77 as A of 6. Suppose I say I is assigned A of 6, 77 will get copied to I, assuming I is also an integer variable. So A of 0 refers to 55, A of 1, okay, will refer to 0, A of 2 will refer to minus 9, A of 3 will refer to 2, A of 4 will refer to 90, A of 5 will refer to 88. So the way these are stored is, starting from the 0th index or the 0th subscript, okay, all the way till the 9th subscript, let us say the address of this is 1000, the 0th location is 1000. Since these are all integers, assuming the size of integers to be 4 bytes, then the first location is going to be stored at 1004. Then this location is going to be stored at 1008. This particular process will continue till this space is allocated for all the 10 elements. So starting from the 0th location, starting at 1000, the last location is going to be stored at 1000 some odd number. Now, let's understand what is the meaning of this word. Array is a data structure of values of similar type. Data structure is an collection or organization of data in which there is a meaningful relationship between different data elements and the way a data is organized so that it helps us speedily retrieve the data, speedily modify the data, speedily delete the data. So here if you see, I told you about array being able to store names and university numbers. Now there is a meaningful relationship between different university numbers. That's why array is a data structure. Now all these values 55, minus 9, 290, these are known as elements of an array. Now the element is referred to by its position. The element 9 is referred to by the position A of 7. I have not shown the bracket for every index, but each of the number 9, for example, is referred by A of 7, 90 is referred by say A of 4, and so on. Now we access all of these individual elements or numbers of an array by the means of an index or a subscript. So this 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way till 9 are known as index or subscript of the array. Here 0 to 9 are all constants, but I could also start with I is equal to 0 and I could say A of I. And let's say J is assigned A of I. Let's say int J is assigned A of I. Since I is 0, A of 0 happens to be 55. So J now is going to be 55. Suppose I make I is equal to 3. And now if I say A of I, A of 3 is happens to be 2. So now the new value of J is going to be 2. So using this index, which can either be a variable or a constant, I can access different elements of the array. You need to know the size of this array when I'm counting in C is going to be max minus 1. Suppose it is 10, then I will, since I'm counting from 0, the last number is going to exist at index 9, since I'm counting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If I counted from 1, then this would have been 10. But since I'm counting from 0, this last position is 9. Very, very frequently, when we are using arrays, in order to access the individual elements of the array, we will be using subscripts, variables by name I and J. This I and J are subscripts used to access the individual elements of an array. So just to summarize, all these numbers 55 to 90 are known as elements. This 0 to 9 is known as the index or subscript. These can be constant or these can be variables, but their evaluation must lead to an integer value. They cannot be fractional. There is nothing called A of 1.2. It has to be A of 1 or A of 2. Now let's try to refresh a bit about the concept. Now all these elements are contiguous in memory. That means 55 will be followed by 0, 0 will be followed by minus 9, minus 9 will be followed by 2. What it also means is, if the address of the first location is 100, assuming the size of integer to be 4 bytes, 0 will exist at 104, minus 9 will exist at 108, 2 will exist at 112, 90 at 116, so on all the way till the last element. Now if you simply take a look at the name of the array, suppose this is the name of the array, A is the name of the array. Referring to just the name of the array, or if you print percentage %u name of the array, it is going to print the actual address of the 0th location or where the 0th element occurs in main memory. Suppose this was starting at 100th location. If I did printf percentage %u a, it would print the output 100, indicating that 100 is the starting position of this array. The starting position or the address of the array is also the name of the array. Important point, all the elements of the array of the same data type. You cannot mix int, characters and floats. All will be either int, all will be either character, or all will be float. Mixed data types only come when we are using structures. We access individual elements of an array using an integer index. Like for example, we say a of I, a of j, or array square bracket index. Square bracket is used to indicate an index. Now in C and in most modern programming languages, the indices generally start from 0 and end at the maximum capacity minus 1. So array indices start at 0. Array of 0 is the address of the 0th element or the first element according to us in real life. So I hope this gave you a brief idea about what is an array. And the array we talked about is a single dimensional array because it has got only row of numbers. There is no columns at all. It is just a single row and that's it.